ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Democrats, Republicans, and independents, I proudly present to you the next President of the United States, Senator Michael McDonnell!
How's it going, Miami Dade?
When you're not strong,
I can't hear you. How's it going, Miami Dade?
I'll help you carry on.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Till I'm going to need somebody to lean on.
Look at this crowd. Look at this crowd. Talk about hope, you can be sure that it's not just the rhetoric of a campaign. Hope and change have been the causes of my life. It's been the story of our country. And we are here today, Miami-Dade, to continue that story into the future. When it comes to what's wrong with this country, the American people are not the problem. The American people are the answer. They are the answer that we're looking for. We, the American people, want a voice in our government again. We, the American people, still believe that we can come together around a common purpose. And we're ready to show the world that America is still the last, best hope on earth. The problem is not the American people. I love you back, baby. The problem. The problem is the can't do, won't even try, don't know how style of politics in Washington. Because America is the last best hope on earth. We're the nation that liberated a continent from a madman, that lifted ourselves up from the depths of a depression, that won civil rights and women's rights and voting rights for all people. We're the beacon that led generations of weary travelers to find opportunity and liberty and hope on our doorstep. That's who we are. And that's hope. That's who we can be again. I don't think we're going to get anywhere in this country by just telling everyone what they want to hear each and every time. We have to tell people what they need to hear. We have to tell people the truth. You shouldn't expect anything less from your president. I know you're not used to it, but that's what we should expect out of the President of the United States. Tell the truth. I want to bring about big change. I don't believe in little change. I want big change in America because we need big change. It's time for America to lead again. It's time for us to lead, not just with our military, but also with our values and our ideals, with our example. I will always tell you what I think. And I will always tell you where I stand. And I will be honest with you about the challenges that we face. And I will wake up every morning thinking about how to make your life a little bit better. And I'll listen to you when we disagree. And I will open the doors of government and ask you to be involved in your own democracy again. I know what I'm asking is hard. I know that politics and politicians have disappointed you so many times before. I know it's difficult to be hopeful during such a cynical time. I understand all this. And that's why, while I'm asking all of you to put your faith in my ability to change this country, I'm also asking you to believe in your own power to transform America. I want you to bet on yourself, not just bet on me. Because the people I meet in small towns and cities all across America, they give me hope. The young man I met in South Carolina, who went from a life of gangs and drugs to become the president of his college class because somebody loved him and paid attention to him, he makes me believe. The veterans I met at Walter Reed, who lost friends and lost limbs and would still gladly fight for this country, they make me believe. I ask you, Miami-Dade, to believe in yourself. I want you, Miami-Dade, to believe again in the dream that we call America. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Come on, y'all. Yeah. If you need me, you can lean on me. Yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Everybody, everybody, just lean.